here it comes, the real monster, the biggest challenge of overall IELTS test, and that is writing for you. I would like to start by presenting the source which I used for the preparation. Mainly I followed Christopher Pell from IELTS Advantage. I believe it's the best material available, and I already have shared his links in the description. I would like to share some key learning points from his content which has inspired me most. I was following IELTS Advantage on Facebook, and probably the first lecture I took was related to grammar, and more precisely regarding complex sentences. In that lecture, Chris was explaining the definition of complex sentences, which is mainly dependent clause plus independent clause separated by a comma. I would highly recommend this video, as it would clear your doubts, and instead of making things complex, Chris was explaining it in pretty simple way. The main thing I really admire about Chris is that his approach makes things simpler and clarify many myths and doubts which are totally unnecessary. For example, his definition about vocabulary, that it must be related to the task instead of some memorized, difficult and uncommon words. In addition to that, I also followed a book by David S. Wills titled as Grammar for IELTS Writing, which further elaborate the sentence structure as per IELTS requirement. Since then, I have followed Chris' content extensively for writing and learned mainly about the structure, idea generation, and overall idea how should I attempt task 1 and task 2 in writing. I have participated in many of his mini courses and even won $1 challenge, where he has shared his structure for discussion essays, and many other free courses and live sessions which he was offering time to time. I haven't followed anything else regarding writing preparation. So whatever I would share is mainly based on his lectures and content. It was an overview regarding source of my preparation, and full credit goes to IELTS Advantage, which is rightly due. Although there were some points, I was not inspired much. Those are irrelevant here. Now I would share how I utilize all that knowledge and what I get out of that. Writing is the biggest challenge for many, and it required lot more effort than any other part of IELTS test. To keep it simple, I would suggest concentrating on the official marking criteria. You can download official band descriptors from the internet. I would share the link also in description to download band descriptors for writing and speaking. You can download those descriptors and thoroughly understand the requirements. These band descriptors mainly are task achievement or task response, coherence and cohesion, lexical resources, vocabulary, grammatical range and accuracy. For task 1, task achievement, and for task 2, it's task response. Understanding of these band descriptors is vital to achieve required band in writing. Unless you understand each part and able to reflect as per the requirements of each descriptor, achieving the required band would remain a nightmare. If you are struggling around 6 or 6.5, it is mainly due to lack of understanding for any of these descriptors. So I would suggest taking your time and set your mindset aligned with these requirements. It would help you to get out of many myths and false assumptions which are irrelevant and causing low score even after multiple efforts. Any professional trainer would also follow these descriptors for their coaching. So to even get benefit from any professional sport, you must need to fully understand what examiner is looking for from your writing. It would help you to clear your mind and ultimately would boost your score. Let's briefly talk about task 1, which is letter. The band descriptors and any preparation resource have enabled you to understand what is required from you in this task. First, you would understand and plan your question. You would decode its tone, that is formal or informal. You would understand general topic and the keywords, which are mainly bullet points. You may follow any structure if it is helping to attempt this task as per the band descriptors. Judging the tone is really simplified by Chris. Like if you are writing to a friend, it's informal. And if you are writing to not a friend, it's formal. Simple as that. Whatever the tone you have chosen, just follow it throughout the letter. I have followed the following structure. For main body paragraphs, you need to target each bullet point and you need to write only about that bullet point in that paragraph. For me, keeping in mind what, why, and how always helped me to complete main body paragraphs. Try to write in 150 to 170 words range and you must need to review it after completing. Reviewing can be a difference between band 6 or band 7. Let's talk about task 2, which is an essay. Again, you may follow any structure here if it is according to task 2 band descriptors. Please keep in mind, your structure would be modified for each type of question. I have followed the structure by Chris. The general form of that structure is as follows. Here I would like to describe some key points further in details. First of them is paraphrasing. I would say there is no need to use synonym for each word in question to paraphrase. There are a variety of simple ways to get this. By understanding the context and restate in your words, you can change the order of the words, or by just changing the form of the word, you can achieve this. The next is idea generation. The first thing came into your mind could be your best idea. Idea must be relevant instead of exceptional. There is no marking for excellent ideas, but for relevant ideas. Make a clear opinion that does not need to be your personal. For example, choose one side to agree and other side to disagree in discussion essays. Choosing an in-between opinion would make it complicated and difficult to score. Regarding vocabulary, I would say relevant vocabulary, not high-level vocabulary. Use the words with 100% control. Keep in mind, this area is time demanding if you need to improve it. And as accuracy is key here to get 7 in vocabulary, so you better use those words for which you are 100% sure. And do not try to fit those words which you have just memorized or you are thinking them like so-called high-level words. To score well in coherence and cohesion, use variety of linking words. Be your examiner in practice. Check if the flow of the idea is logical and clear, and your purpose is conveying without any stress. To score well in grammar, you need to practice complex sentences. But remember, simple sentences are still better than wrong complex sentences. Again, accuracy is key here, and improving grammar is a time-taking process with disciplined efforts and effective practice. Main body paragraph is the critical area, where most people are making mistakes by introducing multiple ideas or by not fully developing the idea you just have stated in your introduction, and hence hurting your task response and even cohesion and coherence. Solution: when you are attempting your main body paragraph, keep in mind what, why, and how. Then of course you have to give example and opinion if required. In what, you can write the topic sentence related to idea you have presented in your introduction. In why, try to expand by answering why for your idea. How, try to explain how it is related to your main idea. Example should be the relevant example, and there is an opinion if required. This was really helpful for me to achieve band 7.5 in writing and caused dramatic improvement from band 6. My journey from band 6 to 7.5 in 2 attempts would be really interesting and could highlight for you the real concerns, so let me elaborate them for you. Even after all the learnings and understanding of the structures for different type of essays, I scored band 6 in first attempt and 6.5 in the couple of pre-tests I had opted for from IDP. Well, those pre-tests were so helpful to analyze myself. It was really frustrating and challenging, and to overcome this, some out-of-the-box effort were required. This was the point where I realized that I must need professional support. And I was right so. Based on that, I would highly recommend to anyone who is in similar stage to get the right correction evaluation professional support. I was lucky enough to find one, and I would be happy to share it in a moment. Due to time constraint, for second attempt, I was having only a time of a week, which mainly I spent on writing practice. I have fully realized that although all above content and above shared material is essential to attempt writing, you cannot ignore the importance of a professional support. Hence, I have opted for correction service from Michelle Thomas. She can be approached by her Facebook page, for which I will share the link in description, and on this given email. Here I would like to summarize key learning points after opting for evaluation service. First of all, introduction. In introduction, for example in discussion essays, when you are stating your ideas and giving your opinion, state your opinion very clearly. For example, by using phrases such as "I strongly agree" or "I am a firm believer of." In main body paragraph, be very concise, and it should completely develop your main ideas but you have stated in introduction. For example, in one practice essay, as per Chris structure, I gave my opinion in the end of paragraph, which was a discussion essay. After writing my topic statement, explanation, example, I just wrote however and give my opinion, which was to disagree that point. On this, Michelle pointed out that I have damaged the coherence and cohesion of the whole paragraph by completely contradicting the context I have stated in body of a paragraph. And hence I learned that I need to give opinion, but in a way that it should not put examiner wondering that which side I am on. The other thing was linking words. I learned the better use of linking words, as they are very important to main cohesion and coherence. You can download the PDF from above link and use them in your text. First write your text and then try to put them in appropriate place. You will be surprised at how many linking words you can use without disturbing the accuracy and how they fit naturally without catching extra attention. Regarding grammar, you have to be honest here. If you are really struggling here, you cannot improve it overnight or in a short time. It's a time-taking practice and you may improve gradually. But for IELTS writing task, you may understand that if you are 100% achieving task response, task achievement, and your essay is conveying the message with better cohesion and coherence, examiner might be flexible in grammar. It means that you must plan your response very well. You must answer all parts of your question. Accuracy in use of linking words and grammar instead of trying to impress the examiner. In short, you must target band 9 in task achievement and coherence and cohesion that may compensate your shortcomings in grammar. Just like grammar, learning vocabulary is also a time-taking process. And you may achieve that by effective practice. That is, over the time, note down the use of words and then practicing them in your content. You cannot just memorize some words and use them in your task. Remember, accuracy is the key. In the end, I would say practice as much as you can. Under exam conditions, under timing constraints, and if you are targeting accuracy, you can ignore time limits for a moment and target the accuracy of your content. So finally, after all what I have learned, I was ready to deliver in real exam. Previously, I was attempting task 2 first and then task 1. And I was always ending up writing around 350 to 400 words for an essay, which was too wrong. So I had made up my mind to write as per the words limit. That is, for essay, my target was to write within 250 to 270 words. And for the latter, between 150 to 170 words. This time, I attempted task 1 first. Although, I ended up again writing around 250 words for the latter. It doesn't harm me much, as you know that task 1 weightage is less than task 2, and I believe my letter was to the point as per the question, and I was able to review the letter after completion. For task 2, I spent good time, that is around 5 minutes for planning only, and ends up writing around 250 to 270 words. I was able to review and it really made big difference in improving my task response. It was accurate. I have reviewed my mistakes, especially in the articles. And I have used plenty of linking words without catching any attention. And hence, ending up scoring 7.5. Regarding PC versus paper-based, I would say huge benefit of opting for computer-based here, as it was giving exact word count, and I feel much comfortable in typing instead of writing on a paper. Reviewing and adjusting was much better and flexible. Therefore, if you can manage the listening on PC-based test, I would suggest to must opt for PC-based IELTS test.